everyone. Today, along with the last week, we are more deeply examining our RNA sequencing data. So I'm gonna share one research paper related to our RNA sequencing. So the why you need RNA sequencing, and then what kind of data you can get. So like this, maybe if you reprogram the cell, or when you culture the cell on certain metrics, maybe let's imagine you have three groups: control, experimental one, experiment two. And then you want to know how three groups are far away each other. In that case, also from the RNA sequencing data, you can make this kind of PCA analysis, which means maybe let's say you have 20,000 genes. From these 20,000 genes, you categorize in these genes to three axes, X, Y, Z. This is PC1, PC2, PC3. And then among these PC1, PC2, PC3, how the your groups are located from the evaluation of the gene expression level. So in this case, maybe this cell are located here, but other cell located here, the other cell located here. So you, at a glance, know how each other or how groups are far away each other. And which means this cell, they are very close in terms of gene expression. But this cell are very far away. They are not close each other. So like that, maybe you want to know some tendency. So from this PCA analysis, you can know how they are far away. And then as I mentioned last week, we can make this kind of Venn diagram, and then what kind of genes or how many genes are differentially expressed in one group or the other groups. You can make this kind of plot. And then like the scatter images or volcano plot, you can know how the genes are expressed and then which is an outlier. And then from this outlier, for example, left is downregulated, right is upregulated. So when you see this kind of little gene, very highly upregulated in certain group, maybe you can know this gene is related to certain gene ontology. Maybe you can imagine, maybe cell binding can be your pathway. So, and then, like this, from the David analysis, you can know the cell component, molecular function, BPs, biological process, right? Biological process. So from this category, you can make plot like this. So, and then you can say, well, compared to control group, our experimental group can have this kind of intracellular biological pathway, many involved. And in terms of cell component, some development processes involved and molecular functional binding is involved. So you can make your story based on your literature, based on your result. And then when you look at this enrichment graph from the upregulated gene or downregulated gene, you can catch which kind of pathway can be involved in your condition. So this is the CAG pathway enrichment analysis. So x-axis is how enriched, and then y-axis, and sorry, this circle color representing the p-value, and then the size of the circle representing the gene numbers. So from this information, maybe if you want to highlight what is the most enriched pathway in here, GSA degradation, glycosaminoglycan degradation. But when you consider some p-value, lost p-value, maybe this, and then many genes involved, metabolic pathway, you can select, and then you can write down in manuscript, maybe this matrix can enhance some metabolic pathway. And then from the downregulated gene, maybe some other NF-kappa-B pathway can be involved. And then for confirming this pathway or metabolic pathway, you can design the further experiment. In case of NF-kappa-B, maybe you can check some Western blood or other NF-kappa-B pathway, some ELISA or inhibitor study, something like that. In case of metabolic pathway, you imagine they are involved, you can perform some seahorse machine study to check the metabolic activity or other things. And then, like this heat map, also they have one group and one group, but one group have three samples, so how they are differentially expressed. From the heat map, maybe you can show them. Maybe if you put this result in the table or in another graph, it's not easy to see, or reviewer never saw your result. But when you show in heat map, it's very easy to understand, and then at a glance, people can catch your idea. So in summary, why you need this RNA sequencing? First, always the so first, you can show them how differentiately mRNA is expressed among your groups. If you have four groups, using heat map, maybe you can show them how they are differentially expressed. And then from the PCA analysis like this, you can show them how they are far away. And then what kinds of things? Things means this kind of David analysis, cell component, biological process or molecular function, as well as this kind of KEG pathway, right? What kind of things are detected in your unregulated gene, downregulated gene, or both highly expressed gene? You can show them. And then specifically, when you know the mechanism, why this matrix is good, why they are not good, and then from the KEG analysis, you can catch the idea what can be involved. And then further, you can confirm your possible PEG mechanism through the qPCR or some inhibitor study or ELISA study. So this is normal pathway how you express your RNA sequencing data. So please remember this. So along with the last week, I will show how you make the plot. So let's start about the David analysis. So here, this is from your sample data, same group, and then maybe I want to know BAC, we have three, and then I want to know compared A, B from the unregulated gene, like that. Maybe, and then you can select 151 record, means 151 gene are overexpressed in B compared to A over two-fold change, and then their normalized two-fold change means this fold change, and the normalized data is this average normalized data, log to level. So over four of this normalized data, and then two-fold change, and then I can get this 151 gene. And then next, okay, and then if I put this gene in David homepage, what will happen? So why I perform this? I want to know what kinds of gene ontology or pathway can be involved. So I want to know that. So I put here, so upload, copy and paste this gene, 151, and then official symbol, and then select species, Homo sapiens, and then list of gene, and then submit. So from the 151, maybe 2 is unknown, but 149 are designated to Homo species. So it works. So and then from this gene ontology, let's say gene ontology. So this is BP is biological process, cell component, and molecular function. So maybe anything you can click, but they suggest the red one. But sometimes you can go other things, and then but most of them are similar in the same BP and same CC and same MF. So let's see. And then here, from the 149 gene, they use 130. And then how, what kind of result can be obtained? So they find out from the 159 gene, they say this kind of term are detected. And then from the 149 gene, 13 genes are involved in this category. So 8.7%. And then they calculate the p-value and this one. So when you click this, you can see what kind of genes are involved in this category. So go back. Okay. And then you can select inflammatory response, chemotaxis, immune response, positive regulation, GTPase activity, related to the mechanobiology, neutrophil, chemotaxis, many, many things you can see. So some people say top 20 or top 30, and then maybe according to your story of the experiment, you have to highlight some, let's say example, response to LPS. So you want to highlight the inflammation, and then this geotherm, immune response, and if you are cell and neutrophil, this or other, maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are involved in some inflammatory geotherm in terms of a bone and biological process. So I confirm maybe this matrix can enhance inflammation reaction. Or if you want to highlight some mechanobiology, you can mention like add a red rectangular, GTPase activity, or some not many things are detected. So like that. So always from this geotherm, you can imagine your story. So and then, but this graph is not, you can copy and paste as a single images right now, like this. And then you can also copy and paste in supplementary. But if we want to use these images in the main figure, it's not beautiful, right? And then you have to convert in beautiful way. In that case, down, click right, and then save as another file. And then as a TXT file, you can mention like David analysis input. Okay, you make the input and then put it in desk. And then next, so if you want to make the graph, you need this gene symbol and then for change. So you click these two because I compare to A and B. Click these two and then Control Shift down, and then you can select every genes related to this 151, right? And then Control C, and then you are making new Excel file, and then Control F, and then as a value. And then save as another term. And then this is, and then you can click this text, TXT, and Yeah, txt file. txt file, but not Unicode. txt file as a text. This one. And then you mention David. Input. Actually, I'm not sure. Input or output? Let's say input. Okay. And then, okay, click. So when you go to your Xtega analysis, you can get this kind of Xtega graphic plus. So click it. Graphic plus. Get this one. And then import. What should import? Your Excel file, Xtega file. So here we are using the sample data. So I click this Xtega file. And then they are loading. Okay, and then click David graphic, and then David output is the one I collect from the, maybe this one, the result of the website, click, and then input it your gene symbol for change. Click it, input, and then you can select top 20 or top 30, so I select top 30 here, and then count of gene, graphic chart, show like that. Because I only collect the data from the up counting, right? So they only show up. But if you collect the gene from up and down, both of them, maybe some red or some green are up here. So based on these images, maybe you can say, you can put this data in supplementary or main figure with some highlight rectangle. So this 1, 4, 6, 7, 10, they are involved in the inflammation. So we can say inflammation enhanced. Something like. And then in another fold enrichment, fold enrichment maximum is 29. So I select 29. 29, fold, they only show fold enrichment as well as p-value. But in these images, you cannot see the up and down genes. So this is less information than previous one. But depending on your purpose, you can use this data, this graph, or previous graph. And then when you want to save the graph, maybe this click and save in the PNG or any kind of image file. So this is how you make the beautiful data from David. So let's go back to David analysis. When you click this cell component, also you can see maybe this kind of cell component are involved. So also you can get similar images from this CC also, right? And then also in molecular functional. So receptor activity, IgG binding, blah, blah, blah. So there are many information you can make it or you can choose. So, and then you can make very many, many, many graphs. But an important thing is that according to your story of the paper, so you can select. You should not use everything, but you can select based on your story. Okay? So next. You want to go to the, let's say, pathway, okay? Let's get pathway, and then CAG. CAG is Kyoto Encyclopedia, something like. So this kind of pathway is made by Kyoto University in Japan. So I, even though I put 150 genes around, but they only use 64, and then they suggest this kind of pathway can be involved. So also class SRS infection, cytokine receptor interaction, measles, phagosome, blah, blah, blah. And then when you click this, they will show this kind of graph. So this star means this is a well-known pathway from the Kyoto University, some database. And then list of gene, the gene you input from the 150 gene, this is detected. So they suggest based on the pathway, this is detected, so they are suggest. Maybe this can be involved. So this whole upper, like SET1, SRC, PI3K, they are located in these things. And then this red one, the gene you upload in David homepage, okay? And then when you go more, you can know the information of this, what is the meaning of this, blah, blah, blah. Okay? And then also you can make the previous David graph, like click, save as another name, and then David analysis, CAC, and then go back to David output, you change it, CAC, and then show them. Oh, p-value? Ah, they didn't have any p-value. So here, you cannot make the David graph using this one. And then made enrichment also, I cannot get. Ah, from this, yeah, CAG analysis, you can save again. Change it. And then another CAG. Top 10. It will show like this. So from this graph, maybe you can say these are detected. So from this detection, maybe if you are selling osteoclast differentiation is enhanced. You can say like that. Okay. So you can fully, you have to know how you fully utilize this David analysis and then this graph. So you have to do many try and errors and then make your story based on these images. Okay, and then let's go back to what's the next thing we have to do? Next one, PCA, right? Okay. So David, we finish how to do it in the CAG. So this is some annotation meaning. So in the David or CAG pathway analysis, you can see original database here, and then enrichment terms, led to term search, how many genes are there, percentage, and then enrichment. So lower p-value means more enriched. So you can know this one. And then when you click option, maybe their default, their option is like 2.1 and 1,000. So I exactly follow this same option. That is default. If you want to change it, also you can change it. So you have to inform this information in the meta method, how you what kind of option you are using for David analysis. Yeah, they show how you download from these images. And then this is how you make the David. So what kind of information in text? This kind of information. When you download from the website, they show like category, term, count like that. And then here, you can see the gene names, right? This is gene names as output. And then input, as input, you can make this kind of Excel file. Excel file also gene names. So these gene names and up and down fold change, and then they are somehow they are late, say, interact with this gene in output, then they show the images. Okay? So this is a concept how this software make the images. These genes, there are many, like this one category, let's say 40 genes are there, and then from 40 genes, maybe they're up and down, they put this input data, and then they show the graph. Yeah, like this. This graph. Red one is up, green one is down, and p-value here. And then this in the 40 instrument graph. So clustering of heat map. So you want to show, for actually as of this initially, you have to show how they are differentially expressed, right? In that case, you have to show heat map. So thankfully, they here. Okay, cluster. Cluster input, as a force change, you click, and then you can export. Force change calculation, and then heat map for change. Then you go back to this graphic tool, and then clustering heat map, and then you input, click it, and then heat map for change, click, and then you want to categorize sample cluster. Sample cluster means we are input three sample, right? Three sample, how they are related. And then gene cluster means from the gene. So I'll try. And then you can select your color, rainbow or black and white, and the range also, what I just show as automatic. So this is, what is the meaning of the sample cluster? This is sample cluster. This compared to these two comparison, this is more far away. And then gene cluster, this is gene cluster. Okay? So when you change this color is changed. Okay? But this is, and then when you change this as a range, like minus 2, plus 2, some other expression you can say. So what is the meaning of the heat map? The heat map purpose is to let other reviewers or leaders know at a glance what kind of things are changed. So depending on the range, maybe you can highlight or you can minimize the difference. So here when I change plus 10 minus 10, actually, if you put too much high value, they only show this kind of images. So which means this is maximum. But so from the maximum, maybe using this software, maximum, they are show like that. And then, actually, but this is fourth chain between the two group. But I want to know single, A, B, C, how they are differentially expressed. In that case, actually, this should be working. Average of normalized data, but maybe something actually it's not working. So when I ask this question to the company, they said from the software update, some are missing, so they are fixing now, but I know how to make it, this output file. So how they make it? So if we put this, let's say three things, just this, we only use this average of normalized data, shift, and then shift control down, but maybe if you're using this 150, you can select this, but I want to show everything. And then shift control down. And then you can And then Control C, you are making another file. And then Control V, Control C, Control V, and then save as a text file. And then this is heatmap normalized. Okay. So let's go back to graphic. So you click input. So heatmap normalized. Oh, gin symbol. Ah, let's, yeah, I have to put gin symbol. Okay. And then I need another one column. And then so here, so when you output the 4-chain data, they show like this: gene symbol B A C A C B, and then gene, and then their value, right? But I only change this B A C A C B A B C, and the other thing should be samely samely appear. So I need this gene symbol and then this column. So here I go back to our Excel. And then gene symbol, shift control down, control C, and then like that. Yeah. Text file. Let's see it's working. Not David. Cluster. Index gene symbol invalid. Sometimes it's not working, but you don't need to worry about. You have to figure it out. So let's open gene symbol. Too much? Okay, and then maybe like you suggest, I will make next four chain graph. You can make it. Gene symbol. So from A to B comparison, we select this 250 gene here, gene symbol, and then ABC average. Hopefully it's working. Text. Gene symbol, And then I can go back to their folder. Let's see how they show the heatmap sample. Yes. T symbol, S should be capital. Yeah, S should be capital. Right. So from their model file, T should be capital. Yes, small things can change big difference. Oh, sorry. Okay. Here. And then. Yes. And then click, click. Cluster map like that. Okay. A, B, C. You can see how they are differentially expressed. So actually, this is more relevant, right? If we have 3 or 9 samples, maybe this is more relevant. And then, is it possible to make the other, like, origins? Let's say, these origins, right? 15. Ah. Okay, this also change symbol. Process. Ah. Symbol. Normalized. Him normalized. Heat map normalized, this one, right? So in case of gene name, the value is too much, so they cannot show the gene name here. It takes some time. So anyhow, depending your computer condition, maybe it works fast or it works slow. So like that, maybe from the after for changing sorting or before sorting, you can show the heat map graph. So this is important thing. So you can do by yourself using very good computer. Maybe it will take so much time for me. It's gone. So what else is remaining for us? So yeah, we check the heat map, right? We did heat map, and then as a fold change, or as a single groups, also we can do. And then they suggest another heat map software, MEV. Well, actually, I never use it, so you can try. You can download this manual. Also, this kind of Korean version, I already share in Kakao, in the English version. So, almost similar, so you can follow step by step. Ah, and then now it's time for PCA, right? So PCA, as I mentioned, they, from the gene set, they categorize in certain 1, 2, 3, some X, Y, Z axis. So there are many difficult information, how they make it. But simply, I show you how you make the PCA graph. The PCA graph, when you click this graphic, plus, again, so you can make 2D and 3D version. So what is the 2D? 2D is like this, left. 3D is like this. So it's up to you. Yeah. There are too many, so I... So import. What is the? So, how you make the PCA graph as a group? Let's say you have a sample, but three different condition, three different triplicate, and then this is group data. So A, B, C, but each group has three data. In that case, you can use group data. But so group data means you copy and paste the, from the Excel file like this. And then here, you are making number two row, second row, you put. And then in first row, A1, A2, A3 should be A. After combining this row. And this is B, C, like that, A, B, C. You don't need to put the color here. And then save as an Excel file. This is a group sample. But when you have just single, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, without any duplicate, triplication, just you are copy and paste this part and output like this. And then make the Excel file. And then using this Excel file, so if you have group data, you click group. If you have single, you click filter data. So here, I using plot data. So from this gene, so let's say making, I'm gonna make single here. So A, C, Shift, Control, maybe without this. Or the, from the PCA, you can use all gene expression level or certain after filtering, you can use it. It's up to you. And then you try to do sorting without sorting and then show how it look good. Copy and paste, Control C, Control V. Before PCA only, you have to save as an Excel file. PCA, three sample. Okay, and then this is a filter, right? I'm not using group. So you click PCA three sample. And then show as a 2D ABC, they are far away here. Show me as a 3D. Like this. They are far away like that. Okay. And then next PCA we've done. So actually, in this software, they provide sample data. So you can simply try to use sample data and then also this PCA group like that. Click it and then they show these images. Like you have a control A, B, C, D, E, F. They are from the their replicate data very close each other. For among the groups, they are far away. You can show them. But this red and this blue are close, and then you can say something about this phenomenon. Okay. So, and then in David analysis, also you can perform the CAG, but actually CAG is originally from the this genome CAG website. So for that, you click this one. This is a real CAG homepage, Kyoto Encyclopedia. This CAG, Kyoto Encyclopedia of Genes and Genomes. Yeah. So you have to copy and paste certain thing here. So actually they are recently updated. So they suggest after making sorting, you copy and paste. Let's say I want to know this compared to A, B, and from the down, from the up, what kind of pathway can be involved? So you copy and paste this enters ID and this CAG input. CAG input, they show some black, pink, or some other thing, and this sharp, some code. So copy and paste this one, Control C, and then go back to this CAG homepage, and then copy and paste here, and then HSA is human. Default BG color pink, default, use on color diagram, include alias, execute, they show like that. And then they show this pathway when you click it. Yeah, from this, where is that? Pathway in cancer. This is a cancer pathway, so some are related, notch. This is you are putting the data, this one. So they suggest this one. You can change images like that. I want to save it, and then you can save here. So click Cancer Network Viewer. Yeah, this is another whole total cancer network. So from the total cancer network, maybe what kind of genes you put in this pathway. So from this pathway, maybe you can imagine what kind of the next experiment can be done. And then, maybe you are using some neutrophil things. When you click it, yeah, this is related to the neutrophil extracellular trap formation, NETosis. So here, NETosis-related genes are appeared. Not this one. This one, right? NETosis. So, this is an already known pathway. From the known pathway, maybe you are putting this gene. So they suggest maybe your genes are related to NETosis. Okay. Then if you click this number, this is the gene you put from the previous copy and paste one. So like that, maybe you can use this data as many as possible. So this is another direct CAG pathway analysis from the Xtega. And like that, yeah, we already show these images and then involve gene here. The next thing is gene set enrichment analysis. So recently, Wendy and me are focusing on this. So here, you can say that, okay, from the David analysis, biological process, maybe organelles involved, and then how much of gene are related to this organelle. So at a glance, you can show them. So I'm going to show you how you can do it. So first, you have to install the GSA EA program. After going this homepage, so you put your email here, login. When you are using Mac, Windows, click this download and then install. Okay, download. Maybe it will take some time, so I will not do it. So I already download and install the GSEA. Let's remove it. Here. Because GSEA need a lot of memory, so I'm gonna close everything before that. Okay, so let's say where is GSA here? Gene set enrichment analysis. Maybe you already saw this gene set enrichment analysis result. So how it appeared? Like that. Okay, I already did the GSA analysis. Let's see. So from the transcription factor analysis, you can see this graph, these images, and then GSA report from for CM REST. So I use three groups: condition media free, and then heat treatment condition media. So I compare condition media as experiment and other REST. So let's click this one. So this is after GSEA analysis. So you can show this kind of target genes are related to your gene set. When you click this, they show like that. So what's the meaning? This is some target FOXR2 gene, and then you put certain gene data, right? Using the XDAG file. And then let's say 20,000 gene, maybe 200 genes are involved in this target gene related to the FOXR2. And then from the condition media, highly positive gene, this is one single line in gene. First gene, second gene, and then maybe 150 genes are related to this from the up. And then another 50 related to the REST control group. So this, when you show like this, the gene you input, these FOXR2 are highly enriched. So, and then what kind of genes are related to here? Like that. From this, from the 1 to, let's say, 202 genes are shown here. And then core enrichment, yes. And no, no means this right side. And then rank in gene list, matrix and learning this kind of p-value. From this p-value, they show like that. And then, also they can show like this. From the 202 genes, they show like that. So this red one is high, blue one is down. So high is more related to this CM. And other HCMF, two groups are far away from this. And then this is enrichment some stat. So this is convert. CM positive here and negative here. So compared to negative, positive is more up. So you can say that possibly this FOXR2 transcription factor can be involved in CM group. Okay, let's go back. And then this other FOX XQ1, and then Dicer1, and MFF2, so MyOD, also SOX11. So they screen out from the transfector protein library. I don't know how much they have. But let's say 200 target transfector. They suggest this is highly involved in your condition media compared to REST group. Okay, this is the meaning of this gene set. And then when you go this REST, a kind of transcription factor is highly located in the REST group compared to your condition media. And then they show like convertly. When you show like this, in the control group, REST, compared to experimental group, the control group show this is more highly enriched. This transcription factor is highly enriched, and then yeah, this is a Lankin matrix score, and the heat, and the enrichment profile, and that is same manner, also same manner. So from the control group, this down graph show more highly enriched. From the previous one, left up is more highly enriched. Okay, and then I want to show you how you make this data. So for loading the data, you have to make two files. One is GSA input GCT. So you have to make this kind of things. Gene symbol, gene title, A, B, C. So let's go your, maybe I'm going to use Pinky's data here. Copy and paste, okay. This 1.2 means always sharp 1.2. This is default, okay. Make new file. First row. Oh, sorry. Like that. Next, gene number, and then sample of your sample number. Gene number where you can get this filter gene number. Okay, you will not count this. Only you are using this 2, 2, 4, 4, 2, 4. Now, how many groups you have? I'm having 3 groups here. CM, conditioned media, heated conditioned media, and free, serum free media. So I'm put 3. Next, gene symbol, gene title, ABC. Gene symbol here. First, gene symbol. Maybe from, okay. Ah, not here. Compared to, I want to sort. I have to see what kind of gene are highly upregulated in conditioned media compared to free. So compared to free, I should go down. Down means conditioned media is highly enriched. 2 and 4. So I select 18, two, not many. And then, and then down, and then not and or, and I can get, yeah, okay, from the 100, let's see, from the 100, I can see gene symbol here, gene symbol, and then next one is gene title or NA, okay. Gene title. NA. And then okay, A, B, C. We have to use normalized data, not log to formed. Okay, not log to formed, so this is log to form, so we have to use not log to form, which means maybe this one. Normalized data, after log to, maybe this can be converted to this one, so I'm using this. And then I'm not sure this gene sorting is working or not, but let's try. When did you try? So gene sorting is working or without gene sorting working? Fifty-one, right? So that's my worry. Okay, so maybe I have to put some more. One hundred ten. Okay. So this is data of input. So you have to save exactly same as one. GSEA input dot GCT as a text. As a text. GSEA input dot GCT. Oi. Is it okay? Text tab 로 불러. 아, 이게 아닌 것 같은데. 오케이. Okay. And then maybe I have to change this. 리무브 텍스트 파일. GCT. Yes. This is input, okay? And then you have to make another like this CLS file. Always this first row sample group number, sample number, group number, and then just one. So in our case, our three sample, but each sample have each group, 331. But if you have one group triplicate, 931, okay? And then second row, name of your group, and then third one, when you have many triplicate like that, but if you have only single, just show A, B, C. So I can make another three space one, and then sharp. What kind of group I have? CM HCM F, and then HCMF. And then save as dot CLS. GS input CLS. GS. Text. Remove txt. Okay, and then now you are ready for running this GSEA analysis. Okay, after that, load data, browse for file. Success. No error. Okay, good. And then, what's the next? And then you can go run GSA. And then This your input, right? As I show, we put 110 gene, right? And three group input. GeneSight database. Actually, yeah, what's the meaning of this? I will show you. It's very important. So how you put, what kind of this category you are putting data at the database, the result will be different a lot. So what's the meaning of this? Let's go to this homepage. So H means hallmark gene set. What's the hallmark? They categorize this kind of adipogenesis, androgenic response, angiogenesis. This kind of gene set has already database formed. So when you have certain interest of the pathway here, you can use this hallmark gene set. Okay? But positionally gene set, which means from the chromosome, maybe your matrix or your certain molecule, somehow some gene related to chromatin 1, that can be highly reacted, right? So sometimes you can see the data from the literature, they mention like that chromosome 1 is highly related to something like that. And then this is the way. When you click this positioning gene set, which is related to the chromosome. Chromosome 1, chromosome 20, 12. And then curate gene set. When you click curate gene set, maybe this all CGP, CP are all involved. But in detail, this so this 3,000, 2,000, some is 6,000, okay? So this, combine these two, the chemical and genetic perturbation. Let's see. Maybe their database of some abuse or some Parkinson or some other drug or hormone. So these genes that are database formed relate to the chemical and genetic. So if you treat some chemical in your cell, you can try to use it. And then chemical pathway. Classical pathway already well known. So many like Hippo, YAP, I'm not sure they have YAP. We don't have. NATAP. Yeah, YAP pathway or some other WNT pathway you can see. And then from the chemical pathway, some CAG database, PID subset, Reoptome or Wiki pathway, Biocarta, maybe you can specify your gene set here. Okay? And then regulatory target gene set, this is including microRNA and transcription factor, something like that. So if you evaluate some microRNA, you can try to use it. If we want to find some, what is the transcription factor, you can click this. And then sort the data. And then computational gene set, cancer gene neighborhood and cancer modulus, or ontology gene set. This is most well-known ontology, right? Ontology means like cellular component or biological pathway. We already observed in David analysis. So you can link this gene ontology to the David subset. So BP, biological process, cell component, molecular function, okay? When you click this GO overall, from these three, they show top 20 or top 30. But if you specify in BP, only BP, they can show top 20 or top 30. So based on your purpose, you can click one. And then human phenotype ontology. Human phenotype ontology, maybe which kind of anatomical structure are involved. And then onco-target signature, immunologic signature, and cell type. Also, if we want to specify which kind of cell type you are checking, you click it. And then you want to say this gene is more related to odontoblast or osteoblast, something like. So go back to your GSA. So I'm going to check. So let's say whole marker, right? C1 or C2 or C2CGP. CGP is, what's that? This CGP, chemical and genetic perturbation, and then CP all, and then CP biocarta, CP all, canonical, CP biocarta, CP CAG, CP PID. CP biocarta, CP CAG, CP PID, CP rectum, CP, okay? C3O. And then up to 8, this is version 7.4. So you have to use this upper recent version. So in Matchroom method, you have to mention in GSA analysis, you are using 4.1.0 program, and then from the 7.4 version, you are analyze your data. Here, I only see the GO, from the not GO or, and then GOBP, biological process, okay. And then, number of permutation, just 1,000, this is the default. And the phenotype label, what you compare? We are putting three group, right? Conditioned media, HCM, and serum free. So I want to compare conditioned media versus rest. Or I just want to compare just CM and HCM. So you can select the combination. So I won't do this. And then other collapse gene set. Collapse phenotype gene set. And then chip form human symbol remapping chip. Okay. Human symbol with remapping. Human. Maybe this one, right? Click, and then run. Okay.
Yeah.
Run, okay. And they are learning. So depending on your computer condition, your database software condition, yeah, they are doing this process. And learning means they are learning. When they finish, they show finish. Okay? So when you finish, you can get this kind of database like that. Oh. Maybe from the chromosome, let's see. This old data, but only you have to see this like that. GSA report for conditioned media and the rest. When I click it, maybe this chromosome is related to the conditioned media, but the tendency is not that much, right? Very randomly. Not very many genes are involved. So it's not easy to say certain chromosome is involved in this conditioned media. And then next, when you go to the known genes, this MIC gene target, it looks somehow they are involved, okay? So if we want to use it, you can use it. Oh, success, which means finish, right? They show result folder, and then they show like that. And then you can see many data, but what kind of thing you have to see? This. GSA report for CM, and then they show cell population proliferation, circularity, biological adhesion, locomotion cell migration, cytoskeletal gene. So when you click it, they show like that. But actually not many, right? So in that case, you have to put all the data. I put only highly broad chain data, but better to put all data in previous input, and then you can see more gene set here, okay? So like that, maybe you copy and paste this GO here, maybe up to here or here. And then if you have this kind of data, and then you can add this gene here. Maybe you highlight this organelle. We detailedly investigate, and then this is some GSA analysis. So you can support your data a lot. So highly important thing, organelle, interorganelle, cytoplasm, you put this one here, and then from this David analysis or GSA analysis, simultaneously I can get this biological process is involved in our condition. And then next, what is the pathway? You can suggest from the CAG or David CAG analysis. Okay, we are almost done. And then the remaining one is about, so this is, you can read this detail and then get this kind of data. So from your control group and your experimental group, this is highly located, positive, and this is a positive in the rest. And then another remaining one is protein-protein interaction. So it took too much time, so you can read and then follow it. It's very simple, but how they show, if you put your gene analysis data, you can get this kind of, what is that? Gene set information like that. And then you can find another protein or another gene from your input. So how your gene are related to according to your database? So for example, string, cytoscape string app. Okay, like that. So you put certain gene, and then from the gene you input, how they are mingle each other. So maybe this gene, you can categorize this gene are highly related to the wind. So we want to say wind signaling can be one of the possible mechanism for your experiment. That is why I check Western blot, the wind signaling pathway, and then prove your hypothesis. Okay, thank you very much.